Welcome back, students. Let's continue our topic with human skeleton. So next comes the spine. Spine is made up of 24 individual small bones, which are called as vertebrae. And the spine supports the head as well as the bodies. Each of the bones are linked by the small joints, which can move a little. And lots of small movements add up and let your spine bend a lot. It is also called as backbone. It forms the central axis of your body. As you can see here, it forms the central axis of your body. And human vertebral column consists of 33 small ring-like bones, which are called as vertebrae, right? In which the vertebral column consists of 26 bones. Around in which you can say 7 are the cervical vertebrae. 12 are your thoracic vertebrae, 5 are your lumbar vertebrae, 5 are your sacral vertebrae, which are fused in adult to form a sacrum, and 4 are the coccygeal vertebrae, which is fused in adult to form a coccyx. Okay, next comes the hand bones. There are lots of bones in your hands, and there are bones in the wrist, palms, metacarpals and fingers. So as you can see here, this is your first carpal here, then comes the metacarpal, and next comes the finger, which are called as phalanges. Now here is the joint present, which is called as the saddle joint, and the characteristic of this joint is that the articulating surface of the bones are saddle shaped. That means each surface has concave as well as convex area. Next comes the patella, which is also called as kneecap. It works as a hinge, so only the backward movement is possible. So this is a bone in your kneecap. It is, as you can see here, it is a triangular shaped at the front of your knee joint, and it protects the knee joint. Now the spoon shaped surface of one bone fits into the concave cavity of the other bone, and as you can see here, here is the joint, and there are strong collateral ligaments, and these joints resist the dislocation, and these joints allow unaxial, that means 180 degree movements, and resemble with the movements of door and window. Next come the foot bones. Now there are 26 bones in your foot, and they can make an arc shape to support your body when you stand up. As you can see, there is an arc shape. And here also the trapezium and the metacarpals as well as the fingers, which are also called as phalanges, bones are present. Last comes the scapula. Scapula, this is also called as the shoulder blade. This one is your scapula. Here is the clavicle present, which is called as shoulder bone. And this is called as shoulder blade, which is called as scapula. It is a flat triangular bone that lies over the back of the upper ribs at the backside. Helps with the movement of the arm and shoulder. So this is these are the scapula present on the other side of the vertebral column, and they are flat triangular in shape, and they are present just below the clavicle. Thank you.